Hey guys, Ryan here at Signature Edits, and today we are going to look at editing your photos when they were taken in super harsh lighting. Bright, blown out highlights, super high contrast environments. Let's take a look at what we can do to get the very most out of our bright lit photos. Let's do it! Alright, so today we're just going to be taking some photos from a recent wedding that we did, and this wedding took place in a beautiful area, but unfortunately, the photo shoot was at noon, and the ceremony was at around 2 o'clock when the sun was high up in the sky here, so you can see we've got really harsh shadows, super, super bright highlights, things are blown out, and what can we do? Because when we apply the presets, as you would, they look okay. However, you're going to find that things look sometimes a little bit crushed, a little bit nasty. What can you do to make this the best possible image you can? So let's start at this image here. First, I'm just going to apply a few presets and show you a few things you can do when you are using presets to get the most out of them. So what I like to do is expose for most of the image. So the skin obviously looks really weird and terrible here, but what I'm looking for is the background. Is the background pretty much where I want it to be exposure-wise? Yes. So now I'm going to take this adjustment brush, and we have some Signature Edits brushes included with all of our packs, but if you don't have that, it doesn't matter because today we are going to be just using contrast. That's it. Just taking our contrast down 100, and then we're going to paint on the skin. And I found this is an amazing little trick that you can use when you've got blown out backgrounds. You just paint a little bit on the skin here, take the contrast away. Now I'm going to hold Alt. I've got my auto mask on my eraser, and I'm just going to click and hold on the mountains here, and you'll see that it's masking out, erasing the mask from the mountains so that it's just on her skin. So here's before, here's after. Great. So now you can see that the skin looks a whole lot less weird. And if we want to just make sure it blends a little bit more, we can add some whites. That's just going to up the contrast a little bit while at the same time brightening the image overall. So we're not going to do it that far. There we go. Here's without and here's with. So you can see it makes it look a lot more natural already. Then I'm just going to dial back the contrast a little on the preset. And we're looking pretty good. So here's just the stock preset. And here's after our changes. Looks pretty good, hey? Let's keep going. So that contrast trick is the number one thing that I do when I'm working with skin tones and I'm finding the rest of the image looks okay, but the skin looks way, way too dark. And you'll find that's pretty common here. So the image is where we want it, but again, the skin on the couple here is way too dark. So let's just zoom in here and do the same thing. Just grab this brush, contrast all the way down, and I'm just gonna paint right on their skin. I'm not gonna worry about their hair. The hair doesn't matter as much to me. Just the skin here. You can see I've missed. I've been a little sloppy in my mask. No problem. Hold down Alt to get to my eraser. And there we go. We'll just auto mask off of there so that we're just affecting the skin. Good. Press O again. And that's going to show me without that red helpful thing on there. Add a little bit of whites to brighten it even a little bit further. Great. And now one last thing that I'm going to do with this particular image is we do have here a nice add texture water sky pop brush or cloud enhancer. I could try that too. And I'm just going to brush on the sky here, get a little bit more detail out. The cloud enhancer doesn't seem to be doing anything too helpful. So we're going to try our water sky pop. Great. And that's pretty intense. So we're just going to erase it off this mountain, first of all. Take my flow down on my eraser. Just erase it off here. Or draw it on by accident, that works too. As long as we're blending, that's my main concern. And then you can actually hit your adjustment layer brush right in the corner there. Take your amount back, and that'll just make it more subtle. So let's make a virtual copy here. This is before. There's after. Now you can see that the edge is getting pretty brightened as a result of the lens corrections. The edges, this vignette here. That's a little bit too much for me, actually. I find sometimes it goes too far. So I just take my vignette and I'll take it down to maybe like 50% correction. Great. Let's move on to some of the brighter photos still. So this one is kind of your worst case scenario. You've got super dark shadows in here under this tent. And then in the background, we've got some super blown out highlights. Now it looks all right with our basic Signature Edits preset applied. However, Let's see what we can do to take it a little bit further. The first thing I'm going to do is this little trick. I call it the, actually I don't call it anything. I just take the contrast all the way down, take my whites all the way up and my blacks all the way up, and then I take my exposure down. And for some reason, I don't really know why, I find it tends to look pretty natural, and then it'll maximize the dynamic range in this image. So I'll take my contrast up just a little bit to taste. It depends on the image with that. I'll just take the contrast up until it looks where I want it to be. And let's just compare. So here is just the stock preset. Before and after. And we'll brighten this up just so it matches. So you can see you're getting a little bit less harsh shadows, a little bit of those highlights are recovered by doing that, and it still looks natural. So that's one of the really nice things about working with these particular presets. You can use that whenever you find a super high contrast situation. So I'm actually going to just copy those settings so I don't have to do it on my future photos by hand. So for instance, here is with our preset applied, and here's with our changes. We'll take our blacks up, whites up, contrast down, exposure down, and then contrast just to taste. Great. Once again, here is the stock preset, and that's with our changes. So you can see it's just a nice, basically high contrast situation version just by doing that. Once again, I'll make a virtual copy of this one to begin with. So here's our preset before, and then we'll do our preset after this trick. Blacks up, whites up, contrast down, and exposure down. You'll see how much more of the sky we're getting back by doing that trick. Super, super helpful. And if you find you want to add a little bit of contrast, another way you can do that sometimes is a teeny bit of dehaze will go a long way. So again, here's before, here's before, and here's after. So just a super way to get your highlights back and maximize the dynamic range in your image. Just take your preset, blacks up, whites up, contrast down. And then you adjust your exposure from there. And white balance is another big one. So this one you can see is pretty blue, or maybe you can't see it. That's all right. If we zoom in here, his head is more bluish gray than it is actually gray. So we're just going to take the white balance up. You'll find that affects your colors a lot. So if things aren't looking right, the first thing that you should try and adjust is your exposure and your white balance. Great, moving on here. I'm just going to take this, copy, paste, so you can see the big difference it makes. And again, take my contrast down, exposure down, perfect. And again, here's my stock preset. Take my blacks up, whites up, contrast down, and lower the exposure. And now you can see this one looks pretty crazy. Why? Because the white balance is really off. It's way too warm. So we're just going to cool it down. And if you find that even this trick is too contrasty with the contrast all the way back down, just take your whites, dial it back where you need to. There, now we've got a really nice looking image. So here is just the stock preset. And with our adjustments. So it's a really nice way, rather than just taking your contrast down on the preset, which doesn't quite do the same thing, you can adjust that. Quick little trick to maximize your dynamic range in your photos. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, please let me know. If you have a thought, leave it in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if this was helpful for you, and I will see you in the next video. Hey, if you want to download a free preset from either our Genesis, West Coast, or Moody Vibes packs, I will leave links in the description below. Make sure to check those out and give these a try. All right, take care.